those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was one of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there were no room for them in the inn.
I've always wondered why the Bible says that angels rejoice over the salvation of each lost sinner. In the same way, I tell you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. Just recently, I've been pondering, is it possible that the Book of Life, the book which holds the names of those in Jesus, isn't open to angels? Is it possible that angels don't know which sinners will be come saved, and therefore this gives reason to their great rejoicing in heaven each time someone is saved? For the angels, just like us, each saved soul is like a gift from God that is unwrapped, a treasure to behold, a glorious example of God's majesty, mercy, and grace. My previous view was, of course the angels knew that guy was going to be saved anyway. Why are they rejoicing? But now I think, wow, they had no idea. What a joyful moment for them. This thought makes me just as joyful and all the more in awe of God as he displays his glory. Well, we are about to meet two angels with a special problem. They are lost, really lost. Now, how can an angel possibly get lost? You know, you would think that they would have a built-in GPS system. I think we are about to find out. Our angels are named Lo and Behold. Do you find that strange? I do. One would think angels would be named more commonly like Michael or Gabriel or Jim or George or Jane or Clara, anything, but Lo and Behold. Who knows what went through the mind of our Creator when he named them? Maybe he had an inkling that these two angels were going to become a challenge along the pathway of human history. Are you ready? Are you in a Bethlehem state of mind? Well, ready or not, let's peek in on, lo and behold, seeing is believing.